Hello and welcome to 3D Nato. My name is Renato, and in today's video I'm going to model this object following a technical drawing. Let's take a look at the top view and divide it into basic shapes. Here I can see three main shapes. Two 32mm radius semicircles that are 114mm apart from each other. Two 22mm diameter circles that share the same position as the previous ones. And the 64mm square that is at the center and has three 13mm walls at the top, left and right. The first thing I'll do is to set this scene for precision modeling. As I like to work in millimeters, let's change it. Go to Scene, Units, and set Lengths to millimeters. Another thing I like to change is the viewport shading. Here I like to set it to Matcap, select the Metal Shiny .exr, enable Cavity, and set it to Both. And for last, go to Viewport Overlays, and enable face orientation. Now we can delete all objects in the scene and start modeling. To do this, press A to select all and X to delete. And as I'm going to start on the top sketch, press numpad 7 to go to the top view. Let's start creating the top sketch. Press Shift plus A to add, go to mesh and add a circle. Expand the add circle menu, set vertices to 64 and the radius to 32mm. To zoom on the circle, press numpad dot. As they share the same location, let's add the 22mm diameter circle. Press Shift plus A to add, go to mesh, add a circle, set vertices to 64 and the radius to 11mm. Now let's place them. As they are 140mm apart, let's move them half to the left. To move them, press A to select all, G to grab, X to lock axis, type minus 57 and enter to confirm. Now let's duplicate and move them into place. Press Shift plus D to duplicate, X to lock axis, type 114 and enter to confirm. Now let's add the 64mm square. Press Shift plus A to add, go to mesh, add a plane and set the size to 64mm. With these three main shapes, we can finish the top sketch. But before we start editing, let's join them into a single mesh. Press A to select all, Ctrl plus J to join them, and Tab to go to Edit Mode. Here we are going to need to delete the inside half of these two 32mm radius circles. Select these two vertices here, press Ctrl plus plus sign 15 times to select more, X to delete, and select Vertices. Now let's fill these faces. Here instead of connecting all vertices following a flow, I'll create the least amount of faces I can. Select these two semicircles and press F to create a new face. Now select the other half and press F to create a new face. Repeat these same steps on the other side. Now we need to create three 13mm walls inside this square. Select the square, press I to inset, type 13 and enter to confirm. As we only need the top left and right, let's delete the bottom one. Select the bottom face, press X to delete, and select Faces. To finish the top sketch, enable Snap and set it to Vertex. Select these two vertices, press G to grab, Y to lock axis, drag the mouse cursor to this vertex, and left click to confirm. If there are faces showing in red, press H to select all and Shift plus N to recalculate normals. And if all showing red now, just check this inside checkbox here. The top sketch is complete. Let's take a look at the technical drawing's front view. As we already finished the main shape, here I'll just check the heights. Here I can see three main heights to finish this object. 13mm from the base to the start of this ramp, 19mm from the base to the end of these two semicircles, and 64mm from the base to the end of these three walls. Let's finish modeling this object. Here I'm going to use extrusions to create this mesh. Let's start with the 13mm extrusion. Press E to extrude, type 13, and enter to confirm. Now for the 19mm, let's add 6mm. Press E to extrude, type 6, and enter to confirm. Now for the 64mm, let's select only the square faces and add 45mm. Press 3 to enable face selection, select them, press E to extrude, type 45, and enter to confirm. Now let's create this inside ramp. press 2 to enable edge selection, select these two edges, press X to delete, and select edges. To create the ramp, select these top and bottom edges, and press F to create a new face. And to fill the side faces, hold Alt, select this edge loop, and press F to create a new face. Repeat these same steps on the other side. The last thing I like to do is to clean this mesh. As this is a hard surface object, I'll remove all the edges that I don't need. Select all these 216 edges I'm showing here, press X to delete, and select Dissolve Edges. Press Tab to exit Edit Mode, right mouse, and select Shade Auto Smooth. The object is complete. If we press N to show the sidebar, we can see that the measurements are perfect. 178 by 64 by 64 millimeters. And if we check here on the 3D Print Toolbox extension, we can see that the object is ready for 3D printing. And there you have it. Another precision modeling tutorial following your technical drawing. If you're still here, it means you are liking the content of this channel. I really want to thank you for spending your time with me learning some basic Blender. I hope you have enjoyed as much as I have making it. So please, consider subscribe to the channel, like the video, share it, and leave a comment. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you on the next one. Bye-bye.